talk to you for a second. Hey, I'm Lori. So I'm sharing my story about when I was overseas and I got trafficked or attempted to be trafficked over in Paris, France. And while I was there, I was a professional model, so I was modeling overseas, and I ended up meeting the girl who would ultimately sell me to a trafficker. And she was a very beautiful girl. She was not some creepy guy or something like that. She was a young girl, very beautiful. And she took me to a networking party. And at this networking party, the man approached her, told her basically that he wanted me, you know, for what he wanted. He was very vocal about it. And he would pay her. He paid her a lot of money that night to sell me, basically, to him. And he arranged it so that she would bring me to this other location so that he could take me. She ended up, in my case, going off and running off with the money and keeping the money for herself and ran off to London and left me basically thinking that I had a modeling job pending, because that's how he approached me about the modeling work. So I called someone else, which was an elderly woman, and she came with me and helped me to get, you know, to speak to him. She was helping me to translate because he didn't speak English and I spoke very little French. We initially met in Champs-Élysées, which is a very public famous place right in front of Arc de Triomphe. We were in this building. If you go there to Champs-Élysées, it's a building called Publicis. Now they may have changed the name, but at the time that's what it was called. And we were in there in the concierge. The concierge knew right away when he showed up that something wasn't right, because he lied and said he worked in the building, but she said there was no recollection of this man. And she was a French woman. She was looking out for me as an American because she knew something was wrong. So basically, he didn't feel comfortable speaking in the building, so he had to step outside, which that was when he admitted to my translator that he had basically already bought me. I had already been sold. And all she needed to do was hand me over, because he was going to send me off to Qatar, where they were going to beat me into submission and to basically know how strong I was mentally, you know, based on what they were planning to do. He said that they were going to make a lot of money off of me because I was American, and that they were going to want me, that that it was a lot of high officials, people involved like FIFA, the whole football thing, not football, but the soccer thing. A lot of police were involved, and even presidential, like the president, their government people were very, very involved with what this was. She made a choice to grab me and to save my life. And of course, I knew none of this was going on. They were speaking French the entire time, and I was using her as my translator. She grabs me and she pulled me off, and as a result, ended up keeping me in her house because she didn't know if these people knew where I lived and would try to come find me. She took me with her, and I stayed with her for 30 days until I left the country and came back to the U.S. This is very real, and I think the biggest mistake a lot of people make is they assume the crazy-looking guy, they're looking out for him, when in actuality, you really got to pay attention to women that are being used. Beautiful women and motherly women are very much used. Be safe out there. This is a very real thing.